1 year ago, I started this adventure of being an indie solo game developer, and to sink my teeth into the concept, I started with a really, really simple project that took me only a couple of months, and I made this dice-throwing app for mobile, and I released it in the world to see what kind of downloads I could get, if I could get any revenue from ads, and, you know, generally just test the water. And this week, I had to update my project that I haven't touched in 1 year. So let's see how it went, and maybe it can be useful to some people who are in the same situation. Hey guys, Ombarus here, and welcome to another episode. This week, we're doing a throwback at my very first app that I released last year as a solo indie developer, and I'm gonna tell you all about it, and also it's a good time to check out how it's been doing out there in the wild. So first of all, I had to do an update because I got two emails last week from Google telling me first that I had to update my store listing for the Made for Family thingamajiggy. And then I also got another email that told me that if I didn't update my target SDK to SDK 28 by the 1st of November, then my app would be pulled from the Google Play Store. So I thought, all right, I'm gonna do an update, and also I'm gonna check, you know, where I'm at, because honestly, I haven't been looking at it so much. I wasn't expecting much, I just wanted to make this app to know how to release apps. Once I tested all that, I was quite happy to just let it be how it is. If you're a little bit like me, when I watch these kind of video, I'm always hoping that people will show me a little bit their management interface. So I'm gonna show you a little bit of what my app has been all about. So I have two versions of my app. I have one version for $1 without any ads, and I have a free version that comes with a small banner at the bottom, and you can pay a microtransaction of $1 to get rid of the banner forever. And if you have a look on the Google side, really, a paid app is doing very poorly. We've got one active install, and if you look at the history of all the downloads, I think that's pretty much one download. So, not great. If you look at the free version, actually, we still have 60 active install. I'm not quite sure how Google calculates active install, but this is not the total install I've had. This is the, like, recently active install. So I'm kind of happy with 60. Of course, that's not gonna bring a lot of ad revenues, but, you know. And if you look at the historical download, actually, you can see that, for the most part, it's quite low. But there's this peak here when I actually spent a little bit of money on Google Ads to advertise my game using the Google Ad Network. And yeah, it did help a lot. I spent maybe $60-$70 on ads that I got for free from Google for registering with their service, and it did help a lot. But as you can see from the active user, these user that I got through the advertisement network probably didn't stay very much. So I'm wondering how it would fare if it was a paid app and I got the same amount of download. I'd be pretty happy. But I assume that if I had advertised for a paid app, then I wouldn't have gotten these kind of install. On the Apple side of things, actually things are a little bit better. There's been 28,000 impressions since last year, and 394 people have viewed my page for downloading my app, and I've gotten like about 26 install. But still, this is the paid app, which means it's basically translate to, well, $24 in sale. So in 1 year, $24, maybe not so great, but, you know, it's better than nothing. On the free version, which I cannot call free on the App Store, but I called Plus, I got a little bit more impressions, 44,247, and it resulted in 309 app installed, but only $2 of in-app purchase sales. So that's not very nice either. Then, if you look at the free version to know really how much money I made, then you have to look at the AdMob's revenue. If you look at my reports here for the AdMob since I launched the game, I'm getting maybe a dozen impressions every day when I'm lucky. I've had some peaks, you know, when I put my publicity on the Google Ad Network, then I got like 227 impression, which is pretty cool. But it still resulted, if you look here, in a total of 1345 Canadian dollar. And Google AdMobs will only pay you when you reach the first $100 threshold. So actually, I haven't gotten any money from Google AdMobs yet. But, you know, I don't know how an indie developer expecting to sell maybe a couple of thousands of copies of his game could ever make really serious money from ad revenues. Unless you have like a huge hit where you get millions of downloads. I don't see how it's possible. So yeah, if you have to make a total of everything I've earned so far on my dice throwing app, I would say it's somewhere in the low $50. So was it worth the like 4 or 5 months of development I spent? Probably not. But I mean, I knew from the beginning it was just an experience, and as an experience it was fine. I'm really just hoping that I can do better with my current app, which is going to be a game, which I'm thinking of having it paid, and I'm really hoping to get a lot of download. I'll probably even throw in a bit of money to do advertisement on Google Ad Network, but I'll have to look into how to do that properly this time, not just with free money I got from Google. One of the big thing when I developed this little dice throwing application is that I tried to use as many plugins as I could so that I could spend a minimum of time working on these features. So what I did is I tried to find the plugins that were the most active that would do what I needed, so that if I ever had to update in the future, I just had to update the plugins. And this is basically what I tried to do this week. I went, and the first thing I did was the design for family. There was something I needed to update in the in-app purchase library because it needs to pass the tag made for family. And then I had to go in the store setup of the play console, and I had to take the questionnaire to see who my target audience is. But updating all the plugins wasn't quite as easy as I expected. First of all, Cordova uses Android Studio to set up the Gradle and the build system and the SDKs, so I had to first go into Android Studio and update all my SDKs, and this was a little bit tricky because I basically never use Android Studio. I just installed it to install the SDKs, and I was having some trouble installing the new SDK, but it turned out that it's because I wasn't launching Android Studio as an administrator. Like, you have to actually right-click and launch as an administrator, and then when you try to update, it's gonna work. Otherwise, it just fails silently without giving you any reason, which is kind of nice. Updating Cordova was really easy. It was just npm update Cordova. And then updating the plugins was just a matter of uninstalling them and reinstalling them. And since all the setups were in the config.xml, it went pretty easily. But then I ran into a problem with the shortcut plugin that's only for Android. But hey, surprise, it's only Android I wanted to update. Basically, when I installed this plugin was the last time it was updated. And it didn't have the latest ports, and for some reason it wasn't compiling with the target SDK 28 that I upgraded to. And I had to figure out a way to do it, and the first thing I did was to try to fix the issue myself. And to do that, I had to figure out how to make my own plugin, because I didn't want to try to find another plugin, because I knew the API would be different, so I would have to change the whole way my code was working with the plugin, and I was wanted to try to avoid that, because it was kind of hard to implement shortcut, and you can only test them on device, so it's the kind of stuff you don't want to have to mess around with too much. So I really wanted, if possible, to make the current plugin work with the new target SDK. Turns out changing a plugin in Cordova is not as easy as I thought. So the first thing I did is I went to the Cordova plugin shortcut page on GitHub, and I tried to fork it into my own repo, and then I check out my own version, and I tried to see if I could modify it to make it run on target SDK 28 or Android 9. But I wasn't quite sure how to install it in Cordova. And turns out there's like this page that will describe you exactly how to install and set up your own plugin for Cordova. And surprisingly, it's not so simple. You have to install a tool called Plugman. You have to call this thing on command line to install your plugin from the GitHub repository. As I was looking to the Java file for the shortcut plugin, I realized that the error was coming from this Android support.v4 content, and I was trying to figure out why I'm getting error on an external library from Android, and I discovered reading the documentation that this was deprecated in SDK 27 and removed in SDK 28, but it was replaced by an exact copy that's now called Android X. And I tried to change it by myself, but I was running into issues. I think it's supposed to be an exact copy, but there's a few things you need to change, a few method signatures that have changed. And for some reason, I couldn't get it to work. And while I was looking for help on these issues, I stumbled on a different plugin for Cordova that was made expressly just to port these kind of things. And this thing is called Cordova Plugin Android X. And basically, it just does that. It goes through your source file for all your plugins and it ports them to Android X. I'm not exactly sure how it does it, but it does it marvelously. So in the end, all I had to do was type this comment to add the Cordova plugin Android X, and then I was in business. The last thing that would be left would be to try to update the app on iOS also. But honestly, I'm a little bit scared of doing it because it was so hard to release on iOS. And I guess it was kind of worth it if you look at the proportional number, like I made more money on iOS than Android. But for $15, I really don't think it's worth spending weeks trying to boot up my virtual Mac and then trying to compile with PhoneGap because I can't compile on my Mac. But now, through all of this, I've completed the work I was doing on my contracts with other companies, and I'm back to working full-time on YouTube, my apps, and my games. You can expect that I'll be back to a regular schedule of trying to make a video every week. Also, my game, I think, is getting to a point where I'd be ready to release it. It's, of course, not ready to release yet, but I'm going to start implementing the stuff that I think I need to do in order to release it, stuff like making icons and making sure that the game is running well on different devices and doing translation and preparing the store pages and all these kind of things that I will need to do in order to release my game. And this is an exciting time, and I'm really hoping that you'll stick around and join me for the ride as I finally release a real actual game that I'm really hoping will be successful. So, till next week, see you guys in my next episode. Bye!